Today's adventure, a beautiful Telecaster thin line with some improvements. Check out what they've done. This is a top loading. We've got the big old spoke nut. Yeah, looks pretty good. Locking tuners. Let's see where we're at to find out where we can go. Doesn't need a lot, but
well, there's complaints about string buzziness. I kind of know where we're going with this, but my eyeball tells me that, well, there's almost enough relief. Not enough. Let's see what the string actions are doing. What are the string actions doing? That one way too high. Wow. Way too high. 664, 664, 6. That one's down to 5, which is still too high. They should all be 4. It's got a little bit of fret munch, but we're going to just spot level that out. And apparently this has a compound radius. Let's find out, get the strings off it. Well, I never expected this. Let's get the strings out of there. The whole bridge pops out of there. That just sits in there. And there's a kind of a bit of a wire arrangement here that makes sure that this grounds out. But as you can see, the whole thing just pops right out. I wonder what they were thinking there. Other way around, Dickus. Sits just freaking. Oh, this way. Just sits in there. That's it. Who knew? Let's just get the neck straight to start with. Wonder if they did a two-way truss rod in this. Well, it's got a back bow in it, so let's release it. Where's my special little gadget for that? I have a gadget for that. There it is. It kind of looks like a little screwdriver with the end cut off it. And it's too big for this particular spoke nut. Well, Ernie Ballsack. No, it's too big to go in there. Okay, we'll just go back to the old way with. I thought I was going to have a clever thing to show people, and it turned into nothing. Just put a hex key in there. So that's pretty loose already. And it is a two-way. So, which means there is no lefty-loosey. It's lefty-tighty, righty-tighty. So I really wanted to go the other direction. And I thought I wanted to go that direction. So we're going to do this. And it's going to catch. Oh, look, somebody likes me.
That was Fred. Fred on drums. Fred on engineering extraordinaire. We're going to get swapping out this electronic drum kit today with a better one.
Well, the neck is almost straight, but we're going to have to give it a little more. Well, still. So what? It's sitting right in the center doing squat. It's not tight. It's not loose. It's just the wood is straight without the truss rod, basically. There it is. That's straight. Let's clean up the frets a bit and get strings on this. I don't know, somebody mentioned compound radius. Let's see what happens here. Up top, we got your regular 9.5. We go to the back, flattens out to a 10. Yeah. Not much of a shift. Where does it, yeah, right? Wait, we're still 10? 12.
flattens out to a 12. There's 12 at the 12th fret. Oh, more people liking me. Yeah, the taper's from the 12th fret up. Just starting here. Okay, I better go answer that. It's going to beak off again. Yeah, from the 12th fret up, it compounds down to a 12. Nice. Someone asked me once, how do you level and crown a compound radius? Well, there's two ways to do it. Figure out where it changes and use the radius block of that type from there to there. Or you can just use the beam, which will follow the original radius. This has got very little. I gotta get a shot of how they do this grounding thing though with this. It's like, I guess you can only really change strings laying down if you take them all off. Because you couldn't, if you took all the strings off, you wouldn't be doing this standing up. That's just weird how that goes in there. I never noticed that. That's nuts. What are you guys thinking? Like, I thought, never mind. Fender, guys, come on. I also just noticed it has that little S1 switch, which is kind of cool, but the switch tends to fail. And I don't know, what was I looking at? It's like $40 for that pot. If this goes up to replace it. Okay. I'd just say don't use it. That's probably what the best thing to do is. Got a bit of a date stamp on there. Does that look like 2018? So it was born. How do they date these things now? Serial numbers are different now. So US 18 is how they do it, I guess. 03 would be the month. Yeah, the serial numbers what's the word I'm looking for? Changed? The format has changed? The old leveling beam. I haven't had that out in a long time. Let's find some new sandpaper for that. That's it. I filled it with sand, I think it's filled with. Makes it a little heavier. The beam is all set up. I screwed up. I didn't take the old sandpaper off. And of course, you know, we had to large quantities of that to get the sandpaper off. Don't leave the sandpaper on your radius blocks unless you plan on using the same sandpaper over again. Look at the pretty colors we got. So I can keep an eyeball on where it flattens out. But the beam is going to gently, like I said, we're not grinding these down. It's microns of material we're taking off. You can do it. Kick drum, hit it. What are you doing down there?
It doesn't
fuck. Well, I got rid of the drummer, so let's peel the tape off this and put it back together and make it do Telecaster things. Today's string boy is Dadario. I'm not knowing. 9.5 to 44. Before I put strings on this, I just want to
reach out to the guys at Fender and ask them to please send me whatever it is they're smoking. Because I am just, I don't know. Is it a thing? Is this like a tone thing? Where the bird just sits there and wogs around? And I'm really not sure that that ground wire, wow, that's fricked up. I almost feel like there's a piece missing. It just doesn't want to sit where it's supposed to sit. And that's the way she's going to be. Another piece of ingenuity designed to confuse those who have no idea. Can you imagine taking the strings off this for the first time after you bought it, finding out that falls off? And if it fell on your toe, you'd know it. Well, I did figure out how to get it back in its hole. It does that. And pulls up. Wow. Okay. Let's try and get a couple strings on it so this doesn't fly off and hit me in the head. All I can say is thank goodness they put locking tuners on this, because that's a fiddly pile of stuff there. As is this. Come to me, fishy fishy. You can do it. Come up over top the saddle. Look at you go. Stay tuned while Dave fiddles about trying to overcome someone else's engineering. You know, we have, I don't know. Is it, am I like, is this like a brain fart? Or am I don't know, is it because it's a thin line? They didn't want to string through? I'm not understanding. I'm sorry, Fender, I don't get it. Spider-Man does not like me tuning the guitar. A minute ago, he's running all over. So, you know, I don't squash bugs. Just, you know, I'll put him on a piece of paper. Or actually, I don't mind a couple spiders in the house. They get the other things that we really don't like. He's just going to hide in a corner and eat things that run around. He's hiding behind SpongeBob. Or, Mr. Bill, I mean. Look, look, oh, no, what's he doing now? What are you doing? Come out. If he bites me, I'm going to freak. Back to things that are broken. I noticed as I was tuning the guitar with the new strings, we have a blown bushing there, another split one there. Let me see what I got. That's not good. Can't have that. So I'm just stealing off old junky tuners that'll never end up anywhere. The reason that happens is this gets overcranked. This does not need to be tightened down like at all. That's why that little nylon washer's in there, so you just get it snug so it turns nice. So this, like, see, that's been totally cranked. Sorry for the crappy camera. Anyway, I think it's only two that are split. Let's get the other one fixed. And I'll save those for the guy that owns it. I'm renaming that the Spoke Wheel of Fortune. I think we're dialed in. I'm still trying to wrap my head around what they were thinking here. I sort of get the idea about separating this from that and getting rid of the old ashtray that was always in the way of your hand. But why wouldn't you just like screw this down to the guitar? Why this thing that catches inside underneath? And I don't know, it seems like a lot of complex thinking to really not accomplish much. But anyway, I'm not going to go on about it. It is what it is. And as I've said before, why can't it be what it isn't? Just once. Truss rod is set. Let's set the string height. Let's set the pickup height. Let's set the intonation.
and go sit down for a while. As mentioned before, I'm pretty sure the string height was set by Stevie Wonder. What do we got? Oh, a whopping! Oh, wow. Then you're working too hard, and the guitar always sounds out of tune because you're pulling it out of tune because you're pressing too hard. And that's more like it. That's more like it. Oh, let's just get this right. The other thing is, everybody asks me about numbers and measuring and stuff. You can look most of this up. I mean, I'm old. I had to find it in books. Or knowledge passed on to me by other individuals. So then, you know, it's like, well, I set my guitar up by feel. Well, once you set it up by feel, I'll measure it, and if that's how you like it, I can put it right back to that shitty setup you had before you gave it to me. But otherwise, measuring is your friend. That seemed pretty cool. Now the pickup height. Okay, the pickup height gauge is coming. It has been fabricobbled en masse. And once again, strings, too close to the pickups. But if you can't wait for your pickup height gauge, Al made a couple of these and sent it to me. Kind of conserved a little bit on the... He made the king size version, right? But it's the same gag. You get that one right or no? Yeah. It's all good. It's all good. See, that's how it was in the old days. We just made our own tools. We didn't have Big Mac. I mean, Stew Mac. Intonation fun. I don't want to hear it. Nick. That's going to be it. Still a little nonsense down here with those tensioning washers on these tuners. Well, just because I loosened them all off because somebody cranked the hell out of them. I'll go backwards. Looking good, folks. It was nice to see Fred today. I don't have a lot of friends. I don't have a lot of enemies either, so I guess, you know. I have a lot of people that I know, but you know, close friends, I guess, right? Don't misunderstand me. Right in your eye. All of them are working perfectly. That's nice now. It was just all messed up. Anyway, you saw it here. The thin line Telecaster from, what did I say? Oh, there was like a ink mark where they crossed over 218 but put 17 on the neck. I looked back at that. But the decal would say 2018. I love the weight, folks. You could sleep with this and never know it was in your bed.
Special shout out to my patrons. Join the Facebook group. Get a sticker. Get a penny box CD. Subscribe. And did I say special shout out to my patrons? A special shout out to Al for taking it upon himself to make the king size pickup height tool. But you see, it works. It doesn't really matter what it does, what it looks like, as long as it does the job, right? All right. Cheers, folks. Telecaster coming up. Another one. Next episode. I got another Telecaster. Cheers. Be safe.